when two of the greatest icons of literature and art speak about two of the other greatest icons of literature and art, especially when they carry their legacies ever so eminently. Natak ki ek nazm ka band hai, huzur. Hame bhi sun le hujum e giriya ki phir na aayenge gham ke mausam. Hame bhi sun le ki hum wahi hain jo aaftabon ki bastiyon se suraag laaye hain un saveron ka jinko shabnam ke pehle qatron ne ghusl bakhsha. Safed rangon se noor-e-mani nikal lete hain aur chandi ujalte hain. Shafaq pe thehre sunehre badal ko zard sone se dhalte hain. खुनक हवाओं में खुशबुओं को मिला के उनको उड़ाने वाले, सबा की परतों पर शेर लिखकर अदम की शक्लें बनाने वाले, दिमाग रखते हैं लफ्ज़ो मानी का और दस्ते हुनर के मालिक, वक़ार नूरे चिराग हम हैं, हमें भी सुन ले हुजूम गिरिया. So ladies and gentlemen,
I hope you can see that I'm blushing. You're doing the right.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Javed Akhtar and Shabana Azmi. And और मेरा काम आज ये है कि मैं इन दोनों को बुलवाऊं. सो विदाउट मच अडू लेट मी गेट स्ट्रेट टू माय फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन टू बोथ ऑफ यू. शबाना जी, डू यू फील बर्डन्ड बाय योर लेगेसी और डू यू फील लिबरेटेड बिकॉज ऑफ इट?
नॉट बर्डन्ड इन एनी वे एट ऑल. आई थिंक ग्रेटफुल, एक्सट्रीमली ग्रेटफुल. Because when we talk about legacies, whether it is Javed's own mind, because they're so similar, both of them, these were legacies that were inculcated in us almost by a process of osmosis. There was no sitting down and lecturing us and telling us that this is what we are aiming for. It was just a way of life, whether it was gender justice, whether it was the struggle against social inequality, whether it was a celebration of pluralism, all these things came as naturally to us as the air we breathe. And so, at least in my particular case, I didn't get burdened by that legacy at all. I think that it gives me very strong roots for what I am, and I'm very grateful for it.
Javed sahab, aapko to khandani virse mein, aapke khandani virse mein sirf aapke walidain nahi hain, बल्कि एक पूरी जनरेशन है शोरा की, स्कॉलर्स की, और फिर ननिहाल की तरफ से आपकी वालदा ख़ुद और मजाज लखनवी आपके मामू थे. तो ये जो ख़ानदानी विरसा आपको मिला है, ये आपको क्या लगता है कि ये किसी तरह से आपकी आज़ादी को मज़ीद आज़ादी बख्शता है या किसी तरह का बार है आपके कंधों पर?
नहीं, बार तो नहीं है, बट आई वुड से दैट आई स्टार्टेड राइटिंग पोइट्री एट द एज व्हेन जनरली पीपल स्टॉप राइटिंग पोइट्री. इट वॉज क्वाइट लेट. And I think the reason was that by the virtue of the fact that I was born in that family and I was exposed to poetry right from my early childhood, I knew what is good poetry. Mm. And so I did not have that confidence of the ignorant.
Mm-hmm. good faith.
Yeah, when you don't know, then you are very confident. But when you know, then you lack confidence. So that was with me, that I knew that I knew by the age of 15, 16, that I can write in meter, I can write poetry, but I couldn't dare to write poetry for a very long time because I knew what is good poetry. But on the other hand, I'll say that there was no such kind of a pressure. And I think we have a tradition in our family. My grandfather was a very well-known poet, then my father was a well-known poet. And one tradition, as a matter of fact, my children also write poetry in English.
And grandchildren.
And now grandchildren. She wrote her first poem at the age of 10. So, but there was no shadow of my grandfather's poetry on my father's poetry.
Yes.
Or whatever I write, good or bad, but it definitely is not any kind of echo of my father's poetry.
Right.
And whatever Farhan or Zoya are doing as filmmakers, because I was a script writer also, there is no remnants of my work in it. So the tradition is very old that we don't follow tradition.
But one second, I just want to say something, you know. Why did he start writing at such a late stage? Because that's when he met me. Had he met me earlier, he would have written it earlier.
देखिए, अब आप एक एक करके पोल खोल रही हैं.
एक एक करके हर का भेदी लंका ढाए.
एक वो रुदौली में आपका ननिहाल है उस तरफ अवधि की एक का एक idiom है ना कि साहब वो होनहार बिरवा के चिकने चिकने पाथ
होनहार बिरवा के हो चिकने पाथ
ये ऐसा पढ़ा जात है का
हाँ
शबाना जी आपके वालिद कैफी साहब तो बाकायदा आप पार्टी के कार्ड होल्डर रहे तो ये बताइए कि बचपना आपका जो है कैसे गुजरा एक कार्ड होल्डर कम्युनिस्ट वालिद के साथ किन किन लोगों की सोहबत का किन बुजुर्गों की किन शौरा की सोहबत का आपको जो है शर्फ हासिल रहा
देखिए टिल द एज ऑफ 9 आई लिव्ड इन व्हाट वाज अ कम्यून इट वाज अ कम्यून ऑफ द कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी द मेन हॉल वाज कॉल्ड द रेड फ्लैग हॉल देयर वाज अ रेड फ्लैग that was hoisted from there and each comrade had only one room which was 200 square feet that's all we had and 8 families shared one bathroom and one toilet
wow
but we were brought up in a way where I was as much Sardar Jafri's daughter as Sardar Jafri's children were my parents
and they also used children. To live in the same commune
same in the same place what we got from it was That money, obviously nobody had any money because all the money that my father used to earn used to be given to the Communist Party and he was given only 40 rupees per month. So when we were born, obviously my brother and I, then my mother had to go out and earn. And when she started earning, then it was taken for granted that when my father was working, my mother would look after us. When my mother was working, my father would look after us. But what was wonderful is that we were in the company of people like Ali Sardar Jafri, Majru Sultanpuri, Jan Nisar Akhtar. And then when we moved to Juhu, imagine we had a small little cottage with not even attached bathrooms, but we had Faiz Ahmed Faiz, Josh Malihabadi, Firak Gurakpuri, and Begum Akhtar as house guests. Oh, wow. And this was just, we were just walking in and out of that atmosphere. So on the one hand, we had this. And on the other hand, we had Prithviraj Kapoor and we had Balraj Sani. And we had all the greats of theatre also walk in and out of the house.
Aane wali naslein tum par fakhr karengi hai logo. जब तुम उनको बतलाओगे तुमने फिराक को देखा था
हमने सिर्फ फिराक को नहीं बहुत सारे औरों को भी देखा
एंड देयर इज आल्सो अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एनेक्डोट अबाउट हाउ यू गॉट एडमिशन इनटू स्कूल जब पोल खुली जा रही है तो थोड़ी सी और
यू सी व्हाट हैपेंड व्हेन आई हैड टू बी एडमिटेड इन स्कूल माय फादर वांटेड टू पुट मी इन अ कॉन्वेंट व्हिच वाज क्वीन मैरीज हाई स्कूल And then they discovered that one of the conditions was that both parents must speak English. Now, neither my father nor my mother could speak English. So Sardar Jafri's wife, Sultana Jafri, posed as my mother. and my father's friend, Munish Narayan Saxena, posed as my father. and that was that. Many years later, my vice principal called me and said, Shabana, I went to a Kavi Sammelan yesterday in a Mushaira. And the man who was reciting poetry as Kaifi Azmi looks very different from the man who comes on your...
For parent-teacher meetings.
For parent-teacher's meetings. So I turned blue in the face and I said, he's been suffering from typhoid and so he's lost a lot of weight. And after that, I made sure he never came. So that was my entry into school.
I must also tell you something about my childhood. It may sound absurd or maybe that I'm trying to be witty. But it's not so. It's real. When I was 4 or 5 years old, I was 100% convinced that Stalin is my grandfather. Genuinely, I really believed that Stalin is my grandfather. And I so very clearly remember, perhaps I was 5 or 6, when it dawned upon me that it's not true. And I remember that disappointment. that, oh God, somebody else. Achha. And then, bachpan mein, ye toh hona hi tha. मैं खाना खाता था तो अब बोले नहीं ये खाना अच्छा नहीं तो माय मदर यूज टू टेल मी तुम जब जेल जाओगे इनकलाब के लिए वहां तुम्हें ऐसा खाना मिलेगा तो तुम क्या करोगे तो मैं खाने लगता था भाई वो तो खाना पड़ेगा एंड देन दे समबडी टोल्ड मी कि जेल में जो खाना होता है उसमें मिर्चें बहुत होती हैं तो एट द एज ऑफ 5 or 6 आई स्टार्टेड ईटिंग चिली दैट वन डे आई विल गो टू जेल फॉर रेवोल्यूशन एंड तो
तैयारी
हाँ ये तो ये हमारे बचपन तो ऐसा गुजरा है
जी
हाँ एंड वी वर टोल्ड दैट मनी इज नॉट इम्पोर्टेंट आई रियलाइज आफ्टर मेनी ईयर्स दैट दे वर रॉन्ग
जावेद साहब मैं एक सवाल आपसे करना चाहता हूँ जिसको मैं दो हिस्सों में डिवाइड करना चाहता हूँ
जी
कैफी और जानसार दोनों अपने ज़माने के बड़े शायर भी थे और बड़े गीतकार भी थे, लिरिसिस्ट भी थे, और दोनों हम असर थे
जी।
यहाँ कई लोगों ने मुझसे पूछा कि मैं कहा कि मैं आपसे ये पूछूं कि क्या उन दोनों में, पहला ये मेरा सवाल है, क्या उन दोनों में दोस्ती भी थी, वर दे फ्रेंड्स बिटवीन देमसेल्व्स। और मेरा दूसरा सवाल ये है, उससे आपके एक साथ जवाब दे सकते हैं, कि एक मिनट के लिए इस बात को भूल जाते हैं कि जानसार साहब आपके वालिद थे और कैफी साहब आपके वालिद थे, आप शायर हैं, आप लिरिसिस्ट भी हैं, आप बहैसियत शायर और लिरिसिस्ट उन दोनों को कहाँ रखते हैं, कहाँ प्लेस करते हैं, और दोनों में क्या फ़र्क था एज पोएट्स एंड लिरिसिस्ट्स?
देखिए, दो बड़े ख़तरनाक सवाल किए आपने। पहला सवाल जो है वो बुज़ुर्गों के रूह को ठेस पहुँच सकता है, दूसरे से मेरा तलाक हो सकता है। लेकिन मैं संभाल के निकलूँगा। पहला आपका सवाल क्या था, जरा सा रिपीट
कीजिए। मेरा पहला सवाल ये था कि उन दोनों में क्या आपसी दोस्ती
थी? देखिए, आपको एक सीक्रेट बताता हूँ मैं
जी।
दुनिया का हर शायर विदाउट एक्सेप्शन समझता है कि जो मैं लिखता हूँ बस मैं ही लिख सकता हूँ।
इंक्लूडिंग यू,
एवरीबॉडी। नहीं, खैर, इन माय केस तो कुछ सच्चाई भी है। ये बात पक्की होती है। लेकिन जहाँ तक ये प्रोग्रेसिव राइटर का जो ग्रुप था, उनमें कहीं जो होते हैं आर्टिस्ट, चाहे वो पेंटर्स हों, चाहे वो सिंगर्स हों, चाहे वो पोएट्स हों, चाहे राइटर, उनकी ईगोज बड़ी डेवलप्ड होती है
जी।
तो वो तो उनके अंदर हमेशा चलता रहता है कुछ ना कुछ कभी कभी। लेकिन इन लोगों में इट वॉज वन बिग क्लैन
जी।
कृष्ण चंद्र, सरदार जाफरी, इसमत चुगताई, रान सिंह बेदी, मजरू, साहिर, कैफी, जान निसार, ये सारे के सारे जो लोग थे, ये एक क्लैन था। इनके घर वाले एक दूसरे को जानते थे, बीवियाँ एक दूसरे को अच्छी तरह जानती थीं, एक दूसरे के घर में ठहरते भी थे, कभी जाते थे किसी जगह, तो पार्टी इनकी होती थी तो उसमें सब लोग हुआ करते थे। तो एक मेन ग्रुप तो था, उसमें सब ग्रुप भी होंगे। लाइक आई थिंक जितनी कैफी साहब की दोस्ती सरदार जाफरी से थी, उतनी जान निसार अख्तर से नहीं थी, थी उतनी नहीं थी। जान निसार साहिर की जितनी दोस्ती जान निसार अख्तर से थी, उतनी सरदार जाफरी से या कैफी साहब से नहीं थी। जितना रायन सिंह बेदी से दोस्ती मजरू साहब की थी, उतनी शायद दूसरों के कृष्ण चंद्र से जितनी दोस्ती मेरे फादर की थी, या इसमत चुगताई तो खैर मेरी माँ की क्लास फेलो भी थी उस वक्त। तो वो छोटे छोटे अलग भी हो सकते हैं, बट आई हैव नोटिस नॉट वंस मेनी टाइम कि इनमें से किसी पर जरा सी कोई बात आ जाए, सब एक हो जाते थे एक मिनट, ऑल ऑफ देम वुड रीच देयर।
क्या आज भी ऐसा होगा?
अब इस तरह के ग्रुप नहीं है ना। जो ये प्रोग्रेसिव राइटर्स का ग्रुप था, दे हैड अ कॉमन कॉज, दे हैड सम कॉमन लैंग्वेज, दे हैड सम कॉमन गोल, तो वो आपको टुगेदर करता है। अब वो रहा नहीं है।
I want to talk to you about progressive writers in a bit, पर वो आप दूसरे सवाल का अगर पहले जवाब दे देते।
अच्छा अच्छा
जी।
अभी देखिए, वैसे तो खैर ये on a more serious note, हमारे ये लिए मुनासिब नहीं होता, हमारी औकात भी नहीं कि हम अपने बुजुर्गों को कंपेयर करें। लेकिन बहरहाल हर शायर जो है, अगर एक जैसा है तो अच्छी बात नहीं है
जी।
हर शायर का अपना रंग होता है। जैसे कि मुझे ये लगता है कि जो कैफी साहब के यहाँ आहंग है वो ज़्यादा एक स्ट्रॉन्ग और एक धमक जैसे। आप मतलब आप आज ही मैं पढ़ रहा था और बाद में आपको कुछ उसके बंद सुनाऊंगा भी, नज़्म तो लंबी है कैफी साहब की, उठ मेरी जान मेरे साथ ही चलना। अब आप देखिए, इसमें उठ की जगह कोई दूसरा लफ्ज होता ना तो लाइन में वो पावर नहीं आ पाती
जी।
वो जो साउंड है उठ मेरी जान, तो एक वो तो कैफी साहब की जो पोएट्री है उसमें एक अंदर बहुत एनर्जी होती है हमेशा, चाहे वो इवन जब उन्होंने ट्रेजिक मोमेंट्स भी जो उन्होंने किए हैं, जो उनकी सैड पोएम्स है, उसमें भी एक एनर्जी है और वो एनर्जी उनकी पर्सनालिटी की थी। पर्सनालिटी और आर्टिस्ट और आर्ट जो है वाटर टाइट कंपार्टमेंट में नहीं रहते हैं, तो वो तो उसकी पर्सनालिटी, कैफी साहब की पर्सनालिटी में वो पावर थी। ऑन द अदर हैंड, माय फादर वाज अ वेरी साइलेंट क्वाइट रेटिसेंट पर्सन, और वो जो रेटिसेंट क्वालिटी है उनकी पोएट्री में भी आपको मिलेगी। उनकी पोएट्री में कहीं उस तरह का दबंग अंदाज नहीं मिला, उनकी पर्सनालिटी में नहीं था। तो वो एक बड़ी धीमी आंच के शायर तो धीरे 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 नरमी से होती बात अलग अलग होता है
जी।
मुझे कैफी साहब की जो डिक्शन है
जी,
उसमें जो एक कहना चाहिए शिको
जी,
जैसे कहते हैं लग, वो मिलता है। और मुझे जो जान निसार अख्तर की पोएट्री है उसमें एक बहुत नरमी एक मुलायमियत मिलती है. देन व्हाट आई अप्रिशिएट अबाउट माय फादर्स पोएट्री, ऑल्दो आई एम नॉट, अगर मैं आपको लिस्ट दूंगा अपने फेवरेट शायर की तो उसमें मेरे बाप का नाम नहीं होगा. आई एम टेलिंग यू ऑनेस्टली, ऑल्दो आई रिस्पेक्ट सम ऑफ हिज पोएम.
मामू का होगा?
मामू का होगा. अच्छा. मामू का होगा, फैज का होगा, फिराक का होगा सबसे पहले.
जी,
मैं फिराक का बहुत कायल हूँ.
जी,
तो और मुझे इन्हीं लोगों के शेर भी ज्यादा याद.
जी,
लेकिन इमेजरी आई थिंक दिस इज समथिंग दैट आई हैव इनहेरिटेड, आई शुड थैंक हिम फॉर दैट. उनकी पोएट्री में जो विजुअल मिलता है वो कमाल का.
जी,
कमाल का.
जी,
वो मुझे बहुत कम जगहों पे दिखाई दिया है जिस तरह का वो विजुअल कैप्चर करते हैं.
वो इमेजरी आपकी शायरी में भी?
वही मैं आपसे कह रहा हूँ कि शायद वो मैंने इनहेरिट किया है, तो आई शुड थैंक हिम फॉर दैट. तो मगर अपने अपने रंग है.
जी.
और अपना अपना अंदाज है, और जाहिर है कि उसमें कहीं कोई कमाल ही दोनों ने किया होगा, तो आज हम बैठ के उनकी बात कर रहे हैं.
मेरी दरख्वास्त है कि आप कुछ जगह सुना दें अगर इन दोनों का, और आप लोग दोनों बल्कि तर्जुमे में अंग्रेजी
के पास उनके इन पोएम्स के इंग्लिश ट्रांसलेशन भी हैं.
जी, तो अगर आप उर्दू में पढ़ दें और आप
अगर तर्जुमे की जरूरत किसी को महसूस हो तो.
नहीं, एक आध तर्जुमा इसलिए भी थोड़ा सा पढ़ दें, जरा एक फ्लेवर आ जाता है उसमें. जी,
तो उन्होंने नहीं भी गर्दन हिलाई. एक तो हैं जिन्हें नहीं है जरूरत, अब बाकियों से पूछना पड़ेगा.
They want it more in English.
Which is what we are saying. Then she'll be translated
in English. लीजिए.
जी.
सुना आपने? क्या बात करती
है? औरत, जादू औरत.
है?
औरत, औरत.
औरत.
You know, the interesting thing about both the poets is both of them were revolutionary, but they were also great romantics.
Yes.
And that I find very, very charming, you know. So it's not always about the flag. It's also this, you know, also what I find today, you know, we keep talking about masculinity and how it needs to be redefined and how masculinity needs to have gentleness and considerateness. It's not only about six-pack abs and wielding power. You see it in their poetry.
Yes.
It is so gentle and it has all those qualities which today we have to spoon feed our children and tell them, look, this is also masculinity, you know. And this was something that came along with them. But they were also revolutionary and they were always also foot soldiers. Mm. So at one level you can think that it is a contradiction, on the other it's what makes them rich and complex.
Would you also call Javed Saab a romantic revolutionary?
Listen. Now you've asked for this question, okay? Now, so I have, because of all the wonderful songs, Ek Ladki Ko Dekha To Aisa Laga, and then 32 similes mein ladki kaisi lagi. Now, this is a common experience that young women come running to me and they say, you're so fortunate, you have such a romantic poet as your husband. Is he always being romantic with you? And my answer with a gasp is, he does not have a single romantic bone in his body. To which he has an answer, I would request.
It happened in an interview that suddenly she made this remark that he doesn't have a single romantic bone in his body. So the girl looked at me with horror. Is it true? I said, listen, young lady, I mean, people who work in circus on trapeze, do you think they keep hanging upside down at home?
Yeah. I've heard you say also, I've also heard you say ki meri aur Shabana ki dosti itni gehri, itni achhi hai, ki shaadi bhi uska kuch nahi bigaad saki. Ji, aap kuch padh rahi hain.
Aur? I'll let me read that, then you can read the translation. Aurat is a long poem, but I'll recite only a few.
But say when it was written. It was written in the early 40s.
Early 40s.
You know, at a time when it was believed that women need to stay at home and look after the kitchen and the home and the hearth, and the man has to go out and struggle. This poem was written then. Mm. So it has a particular significance because of that also, because it continues to be equally relevant even today.
That time, poems were written about women's empowerment and emancipation, like Naujawan Khatun Se Majaz also. But only one share of that poem has survived.
Hmm. And that has become, pe ye aanchal bahut hi khoob hai lekin tu is aanchal se ek parcham bana leti to acha.
Very nice. Majaz. But this poem has taken the test of time. زندگی جہد میں ہے صبر کے قابو میں نہیں نبض ہستی کا لہو کانپتے آنسو میں نہیں اڑنے کھلنے میں ہے نکھت خم گیسو میں نہیں جنت ایک اور ہے جو مرد کے پہلو میں نہیں اس کی آزاد روش پر بھی مچلنا ہے تجھے اٹھ میری جان میرے ساتھ ہی چلنا ہے تجھے
کیا بات لائف لائز ان بیٹل ناٹ ان پیشنس اینڈ ریسٹرینٹ اونلی لائفس وینز ہیو بلڈ ناٹ ٹریمبلنگ ٹیئرز اونلی In what opens and flies lies fragrance, not in tresses only. There is a paradise too, beyond a male's embrace only. To its free rhythm, you have to dance in ecstasy. Rise, my love, you have to march along with me.
Goshe goshe mein sulakti hai chita mere liye. Farz ka bhed badalti hai qaza tere liye. Qair hi qair hai, zahir hi zahir hai dunya ki hawa tere liye. قیر ہے تیری ہر ایک نرم ادا تیرے لیے رد بدل ڈال اگر پھول نہ پھلنا ہے تجھے اٹھ میری جان میرے ساتھ ہی چلنا ہے
In every corner pyre smolders for you death changes the garb of duty for you elegance is an invitation for destruction to you the world is nothing but poison for you change the season if you want to blossom too rise my love You have to march along with me.
قدر اب تک تیری تاریخ نے جانی ہی نہیں تجھ میں شولے بھی ہیں بس عشق فشانی ہی نہیں تو حقیقت بھی ہے دلچسپ کہانی ہی نہیں تیری ہستی بھی ہے ایک چیز جوانی ہی نہیں اپنی تاریخ کا عنوان بدلنا ہے تجھے اٹھ میری جان میرے ساتھ ہی چلنا ہے تجھے
Wonderful. History has not yet known to respect you. Not only tears, there are glowing embers within you. Not entertaining stories alone, there is a reality to you. Not only your youth, your existence has value too. You have to change the title of your history. Rise, my love, you have to march along with me.
Tu falatun aur astu hai tu zohra parveen hai. Tere qabze mein hai gurdun teri thokar mein zameen. Haan utha jald utha paaye muqaddar se jabeen. Main bhi rukne ka nahi, waqt bhi rukne ka nahi. Ladkhadayegi kahan tak? کہ سنبھلنا ہے تجھے اٹھ میری جان میرے ساتھ ہی چلنا ہے تجھے
یو آر ارسطوٹلز فلسفی یو آر دی سمبل آف بیوٹی دی اسکائی از ان یور پام فور ہیڈز ایٹ یور فیٹ یس ریز ریز کوئکلی یور فور ہیڈ فرام دی فیٹ آف ڈیسٹنی آئی ٹو ول ناٹ ٹیری نو ول ٹائم ویٹ فار یو ہاؤ لانگ ول یو فالٹر یو مسٹ ہیو اسٹیبلٹی رائز مائی لو یو ہیو ٹو مارچ الانگ ود می
واہ 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 کچھ اور آپ ابھی سننا چاہیں گے
جیسا آپ کا
آپ ایک دو چیزیں اور سنا دیں ابھی میرے خیال سے
اچھا سنا دیا چلیے سر
رومانٹک وہ اختر صاحب کی
جی اختر صاحب کی کوئی
اچھا
اختر صاحب کی آپ سنائیے جس کا The courage to speak
اوکے
جس کا ترجمہ بھی سنا دیں
courage to speak
Courage to speak. تاب سخن
تاب سخن
یہ دس پوئم واز ریٹن ان 1948 وین پرہیپس دا لیفٹ پرٹیکولرلی دا لیفٹ ہیڈ اسٹارٹڈ فیلنگ انیزی وائل دے ہیڈ ریٹن پوئمز آف جوبلیشن ان 47 آفٹر 15th of August بٹ آفٹر اے ایئر اور سو there was some kind of a distance between the powers that be and the leftists and so on and then ultimately came a time within a couple of years when communist party was banned in india through this telangana movement and so on so I suppose this is the poem where they had started feeling uncomfortable and these kind of poems when you are uncomfortable with the powers that be they never become obsolete they remain relevant so as a matter of fact if you forget the year now you can read it as a contemporary hind sadiyon ki gulami se to main puri padh dunga hind sadiyon ki gulami se to azad hua tum bhi azad hue ahle watan se poocho غنچہ گل کے چٹکنے کی صدا تو آئی پھول بھی کوئی کھلا شاخ چمن سے پوچھو آج ذرات کے سینے میں اندھیرا تو نہیں جگمگاتی ہوئی نوخیز کرن سے پوچھو اب تو پیاسا سرے ساحل نہیں مرتا کوئی موجے گنگو لبے رود جمن سے پوچھو اب تو محفل میں نہیں حکم زباں بندی کا رنگ خاموشی ارباب سخن سے پوچھو آج تو زہر بھرے جام نہ پینے ہوں گے شدت تشنگی کام و دہن سے پوچھو اب تو جینے کی تمنا میں نہیں مرنا ہے در بدر لاشے بے گور و کفن سے پوچھو اب تو پیدا نہیں منصور بغاوت کوئی منتظر مرحلے دار الرسن سے پوچھو کل کے وعدے کہیں شرمندہ ایفا تو نہیں سادگی ہائے بتے وعدہ شکن سے پوچھو اس زمین پر بھی کسی روز شفق پھولے گی دوستو خاک شہیدان وطن سے
پوچھو
So relevant, it seems
very
like
relevant.
It's absolutely...
And also the difference that you just explained between Kaifi sahab and Jan Nisar, yeah. being a... Aapne kaha ki mulayam aaj ke shayar the, wo bilkul saaf ubhar ke aa raha hai.
Yeah.
The courage to speak. My India is now free from centuries of slavery. Are you free as well? Ask our fellow countrymen. One can hear the sound of the blossoming of a bud. Did a flower blossom? Ask a branch of the garden. Is there darkness in the hearts of the desert sand? Ask the glimmering young ray of light. Does anyone still die of thirst by the river? Ask the waves of Ganges and other rivers. Is there still an order to keep one's tongue still? Ask the culture of silence, the keepers of culture. Do we still have to drink cups of poison? Ask the intensity of the thirst for a drink. Mm-hmm. Do people still die in the desire for life? Do people still die in the desire for life? Ask the corpses without a shroud or a grave. Is a Mansoor of revolution still alive? Ask the pathway to the rope and gallows. Will the promises of the past be fulfilled? Ask the naivete of promise-breaking idols. Will the morning twilight dawn on this land? Friends, ask the ashes of the martyrs of our land.
How beautiful is that? And thank you very much. So, both these poems that you have recited were poems of protest and revolution, etc., and seeing how revolution has come or not come. May I ask you to also recite something from the romantic repertoire of either Jan Nisar or Kaifi?
मैं आपको कैफी साहब की romantic poem सुनाता हूँ.
जी.
And learn some lessons from it, no?
Sometimes, you know, when I'm reciting my poetry, to many people get a kind of a cultural shock because many of them know me through my film songs. So after a while, somebody asked me, "Aap romantic poetry nahi likhte hain? You never write any romantic poem." I said, "I do, but not for free." That is my profession.
She'll pay you for that, sir. She'll not let you, not ask you to sleep on the couch.
Rakhse sharara. Do nigahon ka achanak ye tasadum, jo thes lagte hi uda ye ishq sharara ban gaya. Ud ke pehle unhi jhepi hui nazron mein ruka, naram, masoom, hazin, mast, اشارہ بن کے پھر نگاہوں سے عرق آلود جبی پر جھلکا پنکھڑی پھول گوہر لال ستارہ بن کے ڈھل کے ماتھے سے اتر آیا گلے عارض میں رنگ رس شہد نہیں ان سے بھی پیارا بن کے گلے عارض سے سمٹ آیا لب رنگی میں راگ لے ہر ہسی بر کا دھارا بن کے لبے گل رنگ سے پھر رینگ گیا باہوں میں لوچ خم جذب مچلتا ہوا پارا بن کے بس کے باہوں کی گدازی میں چلا دل کی طرف چاہ الطاف کرم پیار مدارا بن کے دل میں ڈوبا ہی تھا کہ بس پھوٹ پڑا رگ رگ میں جان دل جان نظر جان نظارا پیکرے حسن سے اڑ کے چلا میری طرف ایک پدمست جوانی کا اتارا بن کر رہزن ہوش مگر ہوش کا پیغام لیے dushmane zabt magar zabt ka yara leka dard hi dard magar wajhe sukoon wajhe tarab soz hi soz magar jaan se pyara leka aate hi chha gaya khoi hui hasti pe meri meri khoi hui hasti ka sahara banke ab sharara hi hai uske dil bedar mein hai ab sharara hi yahi uske dil bedar mein hai aur kaifi mere tapte hue ashar mein
Wow.
I don't think this needs a translation.
No, you must. I think, you must.
Does anybody need a translation?
Yes, they do. Yes.
Javed Saab.
Yes.
Karen was.
Yes, no, they need to.
You don't. A dancing spark. Suddenly, two glances collided with such impact that love was like a spark set adrift in time.
Wow.
First, it rested in those bashful eyes like a tender, innocent, lovely drunken sign. Then it fluttered to her glistening forehead like a bud, a flower, a pearl, a star pristine. From her forehead it descended to her petaled cheeks as color, essence, honey, no, even more divine. Down her cheeks it withdrew into the color of her lips as music, wine, laughter, the lightning's outline. From her lips it slithered into her arms as a curve, an enticement, Mercury's dancing line.
Wow.
Interred in her arms, it went towards the heart as desire, grace, favor, love, curtsy benign. Once drowned in the heart, it broke from every pore as the heart's beat, the gaze's soul, the horizon's shine. Stealing senses, yet carrying a sensible message, strengthening restraint, even if destroying its design, pain incarnate, yet the reason for joy, passion itself, yet a part of love sublime. The moment it came, it encompassed my life by becoming my lost life supporting life. Now, sparks alone rest in her heart and Kaifi, my burning couplets define.
Wow, beautiful.
نظم جان نثار اختر کی بھی سنا دیتا ہوں رومانٹک
جی
تاکہ پھر آرام سے آپ لوگ میری پوئٹری سن سکیں
اور باقی سوالوں کے جواب بھی
جی تجزیہ انالیسس
تجزیہ
میں تجھے چاہتا نہیں لیکن پھر بھی جب پاس تو نہیں ہوتی گم سے اپنے حواس پاتا ہوں جانے کیا دھن سمائی رہتی ہے ایک خموشی سی چھائی رہتی ہے دل سے بھی گفتگو نہیں ہوتی میں تجھے چاہتا نہیں لیکن میں تجھے چاہتا نہیں لیکن پھر بھی رہ رہے کہ میرے کانوں میں گونجتی ہے تیری ہنسی آواز جیسے نادیدہ کوئی بجتا ساز ہر صدا ناگوار ہوتی ہے دل کی دھڑکن بھی بار ہوتی ہے ان سکوت آشنا ترانوں میں میں تجھے چاہتا نہیں لیکن میں تجھے چاہتا نہیں لیکن پھر بھی شب کی طویل خلوت میں تیرے اوقات سوچتا ہوں میں تیری ہر بات سوچتا ہوں میں کون سے پھول تجھ کو بھاتے ہیں رنگ کیا کیا پسند آتے ہیں کھو سا جاتا ہوں تیری جنت میں میں تجھے چاہتا نہیں میں تجھے چاہتا نہیں لیکن پھر بھی احساس سے نجات نہیں سوچتا ہوں تو رنج ہوتا ہے دل کو جیسے کوئی ڈبوتا ہے جس کو اتنا سراہتا ہوں میں جس کو اس درجہ چاہتا ہوں میں اس میں تیری سی کوئی بات نہیں میں تجھے چاہتا نہیں
میں
پڑھ دیتا ہوں چار پانچ لائنیں تو ہیں یہ ایک بہت اٹس ا پارٹ اف ا ویری لانگ پوئم دیٹ ہی ہیڈ ڈیڈیکیٹڈ ٹو ہز ڈاٹر مائی سسٹر اینڈ اٹ از ایکچولی ا مارولس پوئم اینڈ یونیک ان اردو لٹریچر اٹ از ا کائنڈ اف ا ویل اف ہز فادر written to the daughter. And this poem is a long poem. It covers all the aspects of life. But then at one place, when he's talking about the very idea of living, so I'll read those few lines. Jeene ki har tarah se tamanna haseen hai, har shar ke baawajood ye duniya haseen hai. Darya ka tund baal bhayanak sahi magar toofa se khelta hua tinka haseen hai. Sahara ka har sukoon darata rahe to kya jungle ko kaatta hua rasta haseen
hai. Kya baat
hai.
Dil ko hilaye laakh ghataon ki ghangaraj mitti pe jo gira hai wo qatra haseen
hai.
Dehshat dila rahi hai chatane to kya hua patthar mein jo sanam hai wo kitna haseen
hai.
Raton ki teergi hai jo purhol gham nahi subhon ka jhankta hua chehra
haseen hai.
Ho laakh ko saar bhi haayil to kya hua pal pal chamak raha hai jo teesha haseen hai. Laakhon sahubaton ka agar samna bhi ho har jahd har amal ka taqaza haseen
hai. Wah 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 wah.
The desire to remain alive is beautiful. Despite all evil, this world is beautiful. The torrential flow of the river may be terrifying, but the lonely straw battling with the storm is beautiful. Wow. The silence of the desert may be intimidating, but the path which cuts across the wild is beautiful. The sound and fury of dark skies may cause commotion in the heart, but the tiny drop that falls down is beautiful. Never mind if the darkness of the night is fearsome, the face of the dawn peeping through it is beautiful. Even if scores of challenges stare in the face, the will to toil and labor is beautiful.
How beautiful is that? Thank you. Thank you very much. I'll come to my next question now. Aapne Javed sahab aurat padhi. Mera ek feminism aur progressive writers movement ke hawale se ek sawal hai. Is tarah ki jitni bhi shayari hui hai, khas taur pe jo progressives ne is qisam ki shayari ki hai, feminist shayari jo hai, jaise ki aurat, uth meri jaan mere saath hi chalna hai, to ya majaz ka wo sher hai ki tu is aanchal se ek parcham bana leti to acha tha. Kuch critics ka ye khayal hai, waise to urdu mein koi khas jo hai scientific ya clinical criticism hota nahi, jaise ki Lewis wagaira ne angrezi mein kiya, lekin hain zahir hai Ali Ahmed Surur sahab wagaira kuch had tak Majnoon Gorakhpuri, lekin kuch critics ka ye khayal hai ki ye bahut badi baat thi us waqt ye kehna, undoubtedly ये भी कहना कि उठ मेरी जान मेरे साथ ही चलना है तुझे, लेकिन इसमें किसी तरह का एक थोड़ा सा कंडेंसेशन है, क्योंकि the poet is also trying to tell the woman also the boundaries, also trying to make the boundaries for her कि किस हद तक वो क्या हदूद हैं जहाँ तक तुम्हें लिबरेट होना है, तू इस आंचल से एक परचम मना लेती तो अच्छा था. और इन्हीं क्रिटिक्स साहब ने ये भी फरमाया है कि साहिर वॉज द ओनली एक्सेप्शन when he says ki main samajhta hu tamaddun ko taqaddus, taqaddus ko tamaddun ka fareb, tum rusumat ko iman banati kyun ho. Do you agree with this line of criticism ki ye kuch condescension bhi isme shamil hai?
No, I don't.
You don't agree?
You see, what happens that if you want to find some fault, you can find in anything. But ultimately what you have to see there, what is the intention of the writer. In this very poem we have recited only three or four stanzas. Otherwise, it's a longer poem where the poet has said, Kaifi, that if love becomes a bondage, you break that bondage too. So, if a person is saying this, now the very fact that he is addressing, then every time when somebody gives from the podium, from the stage, or from anywhere, if the person is giving a message, if the person is saying, let's do this, or you should do that, you can say this person is condescending.
Yes.
All the speeches, political speeches, all the religious speeches, all the revolutionary speeches, everything. As a matter of fact, if I am telling you it is not so, am I condescending? But I am telling you something at the moment. So what is the intention? This poem is telling you, and these poems, as a matter of fact,
all these, this genre.
John. These poems are saying that, and not only poems, I mean, why are we talking of progressive writers' movement in terms of only poetry? There was prose. There were people like Kismat Chugtai and Manto and Krishan Chandra. Look at their stories, what kind of women they have depicted, what they have. So they believe in power, empowered women. That is for sure. And as a matter of fact, in their lives also, these women were empowered women.
In their personal lives.
In their personal lives.
Yes.
Whether Sardar Jafri or Kaifi Azmi or Jan Nisar Akhtar, their wives were working women.
Yes.
Yeah.
तो ये खत्म कैसे हो गया ये प्रोग्रेसिव राइटर्स मूवमेंट जो है और आज क्या उसका है कि नहीं
इट्स अ लॉन्ग स्टोरी यू सी आई थिंक वी हैव समवेयर फाउंड द बैलेंस द पेंडुलम हैड गॉन दैट साइड सो देन इट रिएक्टेड इट वेंट ऑन द अदर साइड यू नो देयर वाज अ मूवमेंट There was traditional poetry of Gul, Bulbul, Mehboob ki Gali and so on and so forth. Jee. So only these young people came and started using words which were outrageous, sacrilegious for the traditionalists, like Mazdoor. The word Mazdoor in poetry? Kudal, Mill, Chimney. They used these kind of words in poetry. Their topic changed. The seniors were horrified.
Jee.
Now, In 1936, there was the first conference of Progressive Writers Movement took place in Lucknow, where they decided that they have to write poetry not for only aesthetics and aesthetic pleasure, but for the society, for the change against the colonial powers, against the social injustice and so on, for women empowerment, for the empowerment of the downtrodden. All right, that was a wonderful idea. But you see, everything becomes a cult very quickly. Mm. So what happened that the moment a poet would write a romantic poem, to begin with, all of them are romantic poets, and suddenly they became conscious. Mm. Even if they were writing a romantic poem and a poor romantic poem, they were somewhere psychologically pressurized to put some social angle in it,
yes.
which was not necessary. And anything which was written like this was reactionary,
yes.
regressive. Yes. Then came another movement, and it came after de-Stalinization in the 20th Congress of USSR, then India and China's war. So that they could see that the God has feet of clay.
Right.
So that faith and that innocence went away, went out. And this movement became weaker. On the other side, there were Western powers, which are very, very sensitive to these things. And they were pushing another kind of art, another kind of poetry, another kind of literature. And the virtue was changed. Mm-hmm. So the virtue was, don't talk of the external world. Go into your own world. There is a universe within you. Find poetry from there. It should not be propaganda. They're all talking about this social injustice and so on and so forth. It's propaganda. This is not real poetry. The real poetry is somewhere within you. अपनी आत्मा में जाओ ये सब ये जो स्पिरिचुअलिस्ट टेल यू डोंट गो एनीवेयर गो इनटू योरसेल्फ सो दिस हैपेंड सो दे स्टार्टेड राइटिंग पोएट्री देन केम अ टाइम एंड दे से व्हाई शुड पोएट्री शुड हैव मीनिंग द पोएट शुड बी फ्री व्हाटएवर ही फील्स सो द गजल एंड नोन पोएट हैज रिटन दिस गजल इट्स अ चमक चमकार ने शबशीर ने के मजे मोहकम अज अलफ इंजीर ने के मीनिंगलेस इट्स ओनली साउंड दे रोट दिस काइंड ऑफ पोएट्री आल्सो
बस मीटर होना चाहिए
हाँ मीटर होना चाहिए कि अजीब अजीब शेर होते थे कि कुत्ते पे खरगोश आया तब जाके अहमदाबाद बना ये जॉन इलिया यही के गुजरात के शहर ये शेर है
जी जी हाँ मतलब शायद अहमदाबाद के बारे में ये बात सही भी हो
अंदर से नया होके अंदर से नया होके निकलता हुआ जैसे साये से जुदा होके वो दालान में आए तो इसके में मीनिंगलेस पोएट्री होने लगा नाउ आई थिंक एनीथिंग यू वुड राइट अबाउट सोसाइटी दैट इज प्रोपेगेंडा एनीथिंग अबाउट एनी सोशल इशू दिस इज प्रोपेगेंडा सो इक्वल एंड ऑल बट नाउ आई थिंक न्यू पोएट्स हैव फाउंड अ बैलेंस where they find themselves free to write whatever they feel like and their personal sorrow and their personal feelings and their concern towards the society. Because human being is not either or all. Human being is a universe in himself or herself and a member of a society.
Right.
And one truth is not at the cost of another.
So before we open the questions, I just want to ask two very short questions. Quick questions. I want to ask you, Shabana ji, how much credit do you give to your father, actually to both your parents, for your feminism? Also, does gender inform your art and your work? Has the feminist narrative changed from what it was during your parents' time?
Firstly, yes. Of course, I am a product of the upbringing that my parents gave me. They practiced it. Kaifi was a poet who practiced what he preached. When he talked about gender equality, his relationship with my mother, his relationship with me, his relationship with his daughter-in-law, they were all played out in life as well. Now, today, of course, the narrative of gender has changed, and as it should, because it gets honed more and more as you go past the first stage when you have to be quite strident about it. But there's one thing as an artist that bothers me, is that I find more and more that when you talk about directors, when you talk about writers, they say, why should I be called a woman writer? Why should I be called a woman director? Why should I be called an Asian writer or an Asian director? Now, my point is that hopefully you should be informed by the fact that you are Asian, that you're a woman, whatever your subdivision. It doesn't mean that the subjects that you choose have to be feminist,
right.
But you can make you can write a fictitious story which has which can be a spy thriller, which can be a dramatic thing, which can be comedy, which could be anything. So it shouldn't determine what subject you should take up. Mm. It's perfectly possible that a woman director might make a film which is only about men, but the gaze, I hope, will be female, because unless that gaze is, let's say, in one instance Asian, in one instance, and this is true of painters also, or woman, then how is your work different?
Right.
And my whole point is that men and women are different. Not better, not worse, but difference. And that difference needs to be celebrated in the dialogue that is taking place in the world, whether it's on politics, whether it's on art, whether it's on environment, right, or anything. Because this difference needs to be included. Right. And then beyond that, I feel, when truly empowered, I hope that women will transform the very notion of power itself so that it doesn't become about the powerful wielding, right, power on the, yeah, helpless, but it will become a sharing of power.
Thank you. Thank you for that answer. Javed Sahib, my last question is to you. I want to ask that question in the band of Sagar Khayyami. One time in Delhi, sir, the ghost was closed because there was an environmental law issue. The abattoir in Delhi was shut. Sagar Khayyami ka band hai. Ek mahina ho chuka hai, band hai hum par matan. Daawaton mein kha rahe hain bhindiyan ahle sukhan. Kha ke ghuiyan, kya dikhlaye shayari ka waakpan, ho gaye palak ka patta nazuki se gulbadan. Aur nafraton ki jang mein, dekho to kya kya ho gaya. Nafraton ki jang mein, dekho to kya kya ho gaya. Sabziyan Hindu ho gayin, bakra Muslima ho gaya. Yehi baat. यही बात जो है आज उर्दू और हिंदी के लिए सही है. इतना ज्यादा कम्युनल स्टीरियोटाइपिंग हो गई है. कहा जाता है कि उर्दू जो है वो मुसलमानों की जुबान है, हिंदी हिंदुओं की जुबान है. एंड यू नो देयर्स दिस काइंड ऑफ कम्युनल स्टीरियोटाइपिंग ऑफ द लैंग्वेज. ऑल्सो पीपल थिंक दैट उर्दू हैज बीन द प्रिजर्व ऑफ द मुस्लिम एलीट. और ये सिर्फ गुलो बुलबुल और जामो मीना यही सब है सिर्फ उर्दू में. इसके बारे में आपका क्या ख्याल है?
I think I'll suggest that whoever says that Hindi is a Hindu language and Urdu is a Muslim language, if he wants to have this opinion, most welcome. But he should not say this in Bangladesh or Tamil Nadu. It won't bring, yeah, good results.
Yeah.
If in Bangladesh he'll go and say that your language is Urdu, it can be dangerous for his general health.
Yes.
And in Tamil Nadu,
or Kerala,
if you go and tell them your language, you're a Hindu, and your language is Hindi, you'll know that you shouldn't have said it. So it's wrong. The fact is that the very idea that any language can belong to any religion is not only wrong, but it's stupid. Languages belong to regions, not to religions. Like Punjabi belongs to Punjab, Bengali belongs to Bengal, French belongs to France, German belongs to Germany. You can't have languages for religions. It's not possible. It doesn't happen. It's not possible. Urdu is a North Indian language, and Hindi is also a North Indian language, and both are daughters of the same mother. Mm. The mother is Khadi Boli. Mm. Khadi Boli is a dialect. Mm. Dialect is that language which doesn't have a script. Mm. That is called dialect. Mm. Khadi Boli, if I say, tum kaise ho, main achha hoon, khana khaoge, pani piyoge, kahan ja rahe ho, baitho, there is not a single Sanskrit word in it. There is not a single Persian or Arabic word, Jee. Whatever I said. Jee. Now what is this? Mm. Is it Hindi or Urdu? Mm. If you write it right from side. Right side, it will become Urdu. If you write it from left side, it becomes Hindi. Yeah. So it is as stupid as that. Yeah. Mm. The fact is that, is the script the language? Mm. No. Punjabi is written in Gurmukhi, Punjabi is written in Devanagari, Punjabi is written in Persian script.
Shamukhi, jise kehte hain. Chal,
but it remains Punjabi.
Yes.
If you write anything in Roman, except for Russian, perhaps all the European languages have a script from Roman. Yes. So are they Roman? Mm-hmm. No. English is not Roman. Maybe they have the script. So is language vocabulary? Mm-hmm. Yeh hall air condition hai. Hmm. Am I speaking English?
Or Hindi or Urdu?
Nahin, is it English? Why it is not English? There are four words. Yeh hall air condition hai. Hmm. And out of those four words, the important two words are in English. Hmm. Hall and air condition. Hmm. It is only yeh and hai which has turned into English. Hmm. Language is syntax. Hmm. Grammar. Hindi or Urdu have same syntax. Are there any two languages in the world that have same syntax? Mm. It's not possible. Mm. This language, these languages. Now, if you write it in one script, it becomes Hindi. If you write it another script, it becomes Urdu. You put two extra Sanskrit words, which are generally not used in your day-to-day life, it becomes Hindi. Two unfamiliar Arabic or Persian words, it becomes Urdu. The fact is that Urdu is speaking and Hindi is speaking people don't use this language either. At home. It can only come on All India Radio, where somebody said, "Aapne Hindi mein samachar sune hai?" Unka, "Nahi, humne samachar mein Hindi suni." So that is artificial. This divide is artificial. But anyway, after a long time, both the Shelleys, both the languages have developed their own tradition, their own culture. Doesn't matter, let it be. But they are helpful. You cannot speak Urdu without using Hindi words.
They complement.
Any Hindi dictionary will have at least 5,000 to 6,000, if not more, words from Persian.
Yes.
Leave aside Urdu.
Yes, forget it.
We don't even know these are Persian words. We don't know from where these words have come. I give you an example. You give me an example.
Please,
DJ. I
will
read a small paragraph to people and ask, have you understood? Did you find any difficulty in it? Did you find any unfamiliar word? Ek makan ke ek kamre mein ek gora chitta aadmi ek nanna munna bachcha balti se nahaye bavarchi ne nashta diya nashte mein urad ki dal aur toast tha. आदमी उठा चिक हटाई संदूक खोला उसमें से एक पिस्तौल निकाला दीवार पे टंगी बंदूक ली और बाहर चला गया बच्चा बेबस देखता रहा. Any difficulty? No. I mean.
And क्या?
What did she say?
She said I didn't understand the word. अंग्रेजी में.
You have not understood. Then believe me, you have not understood at least 20 languages at the moment. I'll tell you how. Makan, ek makan, makan is Arabic. Kamre mein kamra, Italian. Ek gora chitta aadmi, chitta Punjabi. Aadmi, Arabic. Bachcha, Persian. Nanna munna, nanno, Gujarati. Balti, Portuguese. Bavarchi, Turkish. Urad, Tamil. Toast, English.
Toast.
Chick, Turkish again. Sanduk, Turkish again. Pistol, English, pistol. Divar, Persian. Banduk, Turkish. Bebas, Sanskrit.
Buff. Wow.
Javed Sahab. Super. I'm sure we are running short of time, but I'm sure our audience also has questions to ask. But with the permission of the audience, may I ask you to please recite one of your own nazms? Yes. Before? Yes. Yes. Thank you.
I'm asking for Sazish.
Sazish?
Because that's his new. It's your newest poem, and it's about
Sazish.
Words.
Yeah. Ji. Agar aap Sazish inayat farmane.
Thank you. It's an unpublished poem I have written last week. So that is the USP. Sazish. Conspiracy. मुझे तो ये लगता है जैसे किसी ने ये साजिश रची है कि लफ्ज और मानी में जो रिश्ता है उसको जितना भी मुमकिन हो कमजोर कर दो.
क्या बात. वाह
वाह.
मुझे तो ये लगता है जैसे किसी ने ये साजिश रची है कि लफ्ज और मानी में जो रिश्ता है उसको जितना भी मुमकिन है कमजोर कर दो. कि हर लफ्ज बन जाए बेमाने आवाज.
वाह.
फिर सारी आवाजों को ऐसे घटमट करो ऐसे गूंधो के एक शोर कर दो.
क्या बात. वाह.
ये शोर एक ऐसा अंधेरा बुनेगा कि जिसमें भटक जाएंगे अपने लफ्जों से बिछड़े हुए सारे गूंगे मानी.
वाह वाह.
भटकते हुए रास्ता ढूंढते वक्त की खाई में गिर के मर जाएंगे.
वाह.
और फिर आके बाजार में खोखले लफ्ज बेबस गुलामों की मानिंद बिक जाएंगे.
बेबस गुलामों की.
वाह. ये गुलाम अपने आकाओं के एक इशारे पे इस तरह यूरिश करेंगे द वे दे विल अटैक कि सारे ख्यालात की सब हसी की सब इमारत द ब्यूटिफुल स्ट्रक्चर्स ऑफ वंडरफुल थॉट्स सारे ख्यालात की सब इमारत सारे जज्बात के शीशा घर मुनहदिम होके रहे.
वाह वाह वाह.
हर तरफ जहन की बस्तियों में यही देखने को मिलेगा कि एक अफरा तफरी मची है.
वाह.
मुझे तो ये लगता है जैसे किसी ने साजिश
रची. वाह वाह वाह.
मगर कोई है जो ये कहता है मुझसे कहे आज भी लफ्ज़ो मानी के ऐसे परिस्तार शैदा जो मानी को यूं बेजबां लफ्ज को ऐसे नीलाम होने न देंगे. अभी ऐसे दीवाने हैं जो ख्यालात का सारे जज्बात का दिल की हर बात का ऐसा अंजाम होने न देंगे. अगर ऐसे कुछ लोग हैं तो कहाँ हैं वो दुनिया के जिस कोने में हैं जहां हैं उन्हें ये बता दो कि वक्त के लफ्ज और मानी बचाने की खातिर जरा सी ही मोहलत बची है. मुझे तो ये लगता है जैसे किसी ने साजिश
रची है. वाह वाह वाह. बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया. डू वी हैव टाइम फॉर टू क्वेश्चंस? यस यस.
शबाना जी, कुड यू शेयर सम ऑफ योर फॉन्ड मेमोरीज विद फैज एंड मे बी हाउ ही इन्फ्लुएंस्ड यू?
इट्स अ वेरी लॉन्ग आंसर. इट्स रियली अ वेरी लॉन्ग आंसर बट फैज इज रियली रियली अ वेरी डीप favorite of mine. His poetry, his book, Sare Sukhan Hamare, continues to be by my bedside for the last 40 years. I'm a huge fan.
Sir, abhi samay nahi hai, varna I would have told you a very interesting story that how I met Faiz Sahab for the first time. He came to India perhaps after 20, 25 years in late 60s. I was perhaps 20, 21 years old. And I spent the whole night with him. Wow. Drinking with him, talking to him, and then I slept in his bedroom. How it happened, someday I'll tell you.
You should also go on YouTube and see Shabana Ji's interview about Faiz meeting him in Russia. That's also very interesting. Yes, is there any other question? Yes, madam.
Javed Sahab, can we request you just to say a few lines? Aapke Sahabzade Farhan ne Zindagi Na Mile Dobara mein, he quoted a few lines of yours. Aapne likhi hain.
Ji, ji.
Aur wo hum jab सीडी खरीदते हैं या स्पॉटिफाई कहीं भी जाते हैं वो मिलती नहीं है वो लाइन्स हमें और वो खाली वो पिक्चर में ही देखी थी हमने
तो अगर आपको याद है तो सुना दीजिए.
मुझे तो यही याद है कि मैंने वो फरहान को दिया था.
तो मतलब तो मतलब अब फरहान को बुलाना पड़ेगा यहाँ पे.
जी जी जी.
नया हुक्मनामा वो भी सुना दीजिए
सर.
नया हुक्मनामा सुना दे
सर. कहाँ के रहने वाले हैं आप?
The new ordinance.
New ordinance. The naya hukumnama. Ab iska translation.
Never mind. You can just.
I'm concerned about her.
We can call her aside. I'm for her.
Unko alag se tarjuma suna denge. And we'll end with this.
Kisi ka hukm hai. Sari hawaein. Hamesha chalne se pehle bataein ki unki samt kya hai. डायरेक्शन क्या है, किस डायरेक्शन में जा रही है. किसी का हुक्म है सारी हवाएं, हमेशा चलने से पहले बताएं कि उनकी समत क्या है. हवाओं को बताना ये भी होगा, चलेंगी जब तो क्या रफ्तार होगी. कि आंधी की इजाज़त अब नहीं है. हमारी रेत की सब ये फसीलें, ये कागज़ के महल जो बन रहे हैं, हिफाजत इनकी करना है ज़रूरी. और आंधी है पुरानी इनकी दुश्मन, ये सभी जान. किसी का हुक्म है दरिया की लहरें, जरा ये सरकशी कम कर लें, अपनी हद में ठहरे. उभरना फिर बिखरना और बिखर कर फिर उभरना, गलत थे उनका ये हंगामा करना. ये सब है सिर्फ वहशत की अलामत, बगावत की अलामत. बगावत तो नहीं बर्दाश्त होगी, ये वहशत तो नहीं बर्दाश्त. अगर लहरों को है दरिया में रहना, तो उनको होगा आप चुपचाप बहना.
वाह वाह.
किसी का हुक्म है इस गुलसिता में, बस अब एक रंग के ही फूल होंगे. कुछ अफसर होंगे जो ये तय करेंगे गुलिस्तां किस तरह बनना है कल का. यकीनन फूल यक रंगी तो होंगे, मगर ये रंग होगा कितना गहरा कितना हल्का, ये अफसर तय करेंगे.
वाह वाह वाह.
किसी को ये कोई कैसे बताए, गुलिस्तां में कहीं भी फूल यक रंगी नहीं होते, कभी हो ही नहीं सकते. कि हर एक रंग में छुपकर बहुत से रंग रहते.
वाह वाह.
जिन्होंने बाग यकरंगी बनाना चाहे थे, उनको जरा देखो.
वाह.
कि जब एक रंग में 100 रंग जाहिर हो गए हैं, तो वो अब कितने परेशान हैं, वो कितने तंग रहते.
वाह वाह, क्या इशारा है. वाह वाह वाह.
किसी को ये कोई कैसे बताए, हवाएं और लहरें कब किसी का हुक्म सुनती है. हवाएं हाकिमों की मुट्ठियों में, हथकड़ी में, कैद खानों में नहीं रुकती. ये लहरें रोकी जाती हैं तो दरिया कितना भी हो पुरसुकून शांत, तो दरिया कितना भी हो पुरसुकून बेताब होता है. और इस बेताबी का अगला कदम सैलाब होता है.
वाह वाह. बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया.